Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Yunus Alea, and today I will be showing you how to collect files in Premiere Pro. This is super handy when you finished a project and you just want to save your project for later on, but you only want to keep the bare essentials to keep that project working. You want to get rid of everything that you didn't use, and you just want to put everything nicely tucked in together and nicely organized, and then you can just back up your project. Or if you want to share it with someone else that continues working on your project file and you want to make sure that he has all the files that you use in your project file. Maybe you use some stock footage that you took from a different folder. You downloaded some music, which is still in your download folder, which you dragged in Premiere Pro, and everything is at a different location. And you want to get all these files that you used in your project file to collect them in your project of Premiere Pro. So that's basically it. It will get everything in the same folder and just collect all the files that are needed to create this project. So we will jump into Adobe Premiere Pro and see how this is done. Also, if you like this video, please give it a like. Also, subscribe to the channel. Hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. That would be great. Without further ado, let's get started. All right, so here I am in Adobe Premiere Pro with a project that I have been working on. And now I want to back up this project so I can come back to it later and make sure that everything will still work. Maybe I will change something in my download directory where I use some music from, or I will go and the sound effects, for example, get moved because these come from a different folder where I store all my stock sound effects. And all these things just come from different places. I didn't drag them into the project folder each time. So if I would give this project file to someone, he will be missing a lot of these files. So now I just want to organize everything into the same folder and just collect the entire project. So as you can see here, I have a big, big structure. I would also suggest that you put everything that kind of belongs together into a separate folder and just rename everything, maybe. But yeah, that's not for this tutorial. It's kind of a mess over here, so don't pay too much attention to this. So basically what you'll do is you go to your sequence that you want to save. If you have multiple sequences that you want to save, make sure that you select that later on. But also, most of your projects end up in one sequence. So if you don't want the second one to be exported, you can just ignore that for now. Make sure it has a decent name just so you actually remember what you've been doing. There we go. So I just renamed it. What I will do now is just go to File, and over here you will see Project Manager, and in here you can actually do everything of this. So you will see your sequences in the Project Manager, and you just want to make sure that everything in the sequence short film Back to the Future is backed up, but all the rest are just sequences of other stuff I've been doing and didn't really belong to this project. So if you want, you can check it on or just leave it unchecked. Then over here you have the resulting project where you can collect the files and copy it to the new location, or you can consolidate and transcode all these files so you have them smaller in a different format. So that's completely up to you. If you would click on that, you will go for an NDXHR, which is almost lossless. So I will just go for collect the files and copy to new location because my GH5 doesn't necessarily have very big files. Then you have a few other options over here to exclude all the unused footage. Maybe you have some clips in Premiere Pro that you didn't end up using in your final edit, and that's also taking up space. So if you don't want that, you just select exclude unused clips. If you do want these provided into your project file, for example, if you did a base edit, but someone else might still want to re-import one of the files that you haven't used, you can uncheck that, and that will take everything that you have in this project to the new location. So I don't need that exclude unused clips because it's actually a finished project. It's published, so I can exclude everything that I didn't use. And then include audio confirm data. Okay, that's all the audio, and including the preview files. If you want it to be immediately rendered, you can do that as well. Or if someone has to just re-render it, that's completely up to you. Maybe you can also uncheck that if you want a lower file size. And that's basically it. Then right here you have the destination path, which you can browse and yeah, just set it at your location that you want to export this. And then you have the disk space, your available disk space. So I have 2.3 terabytes free, and I have a project size that is currently unknown, but you can simply click on calculate. That will calculate the necessary
memory storage space for this project. So this project is around 9 gigabytes big. So that's okay for me. It's still a video project. So once we click OK, it will require your project to be saved one last time. So just click yes. So now once it's done collecting all the files, you just go to the destination folder and it will most likely be called copied and then underscore the project file. And then right here, we'll see everything together. So I have my project file from Premiere, but I also connected it and linked it to After Effects. So I have some link comps in After Effects. And then right here, you'll see that project file, which is super nice that Premiere also includes these and some title animation graphics, all the sounds that I used, all the clips I used, and the media cache right here and video previews. This is a nicely structured file because everything that is necessary in order for this project to work is just in here. And just to check, I'm going to double click on it and see if it works. There we go. And as you can see, the preview is already green. So that way you can simply quickly replay your video. Great.
All right, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for filmmakers and any kind of creative digital artist. And if you would buy something from our website, it would really help to support this channel. So that would be awesome. And apart from that, I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.